to another episode of Super Mario Sunshine. Let's continue this. So where we left off last time, we just did the first shine in Peanut Park. Or the second shine, my bad. Beach Canyon Secret. It's a good reason why you should get all those blue coins if you're going for under the baskets immediately, because they respawn. And it can become kind of confusing. I mean, you can see the blue coins under there. They're still there, but just save yourself the hassle. Absolutely destroyed him. Yeah. Yeah, but anyways, I have something to talk about. Super Mario Sunshine is one of the main reasons for my personal thesis that the sixth generation of consoles was the best in gaming history. It's one of many reasons. I mean, this generation just had banger after banger released. I mean, there's obviously Mario Sunshine. That was the Sonic Adventure 2 was released, but you also got Ratchet and Clank on the PS2, you had... Oh, what else? There was the first Sonic Adventure, that was good too. Check out the Let's Play of Sonic Adventure 1 at some point. Watch this. Yeah, you can do that too, you can slide. Do water slide. Yeah, like I was saying, there was the first Sonic Adventure, there was also Pac-Man World 2, there was Sonic Heroes, Battlefield Bikini Bottom, one of the best licensed games, just the best licensed game. And then you had the Dreamcast, which hits, like, obviously the Sonic Adventure games. There was also Jetline Radio, that had the best version of Rayman 2, best version of Frogger 2, Swampy's Revenge. A Crazy Taxi, and so many more hits. You also had Psychonauts on the Xbox, Crash Twin Sanity. I hope that game is the best Crash Bandicoot game ever, by a long shot. You had... what else? Simpsons Hit and Run was pretty alright. What shine was this again? My bad. Red coins and the pirate ships. So here's where we need a bunch of blue coins. I mean, you also had, plenty more. There was Sly Cooper was this generation. There was Jack and Daxter. Along with Ratchet and Clank, I mentioned those already, that was the PS2 platforming trio. Those games were all really good. You also had, just tons of them. That's just a few. I'm kind of looking at my shelf. Oh, look at that. Super Mario Odyssey, 15 years before edition. And watch this, if I could somehow... kill them all at once. But yeah, I mean, and obviously there's... I just think the consoles of this generation have the best games. The the best controllers. You just need GameCube controllers, the best in video game history. My opinion, up there with the Xbox 360 controller. What else? I mean, this is also the first generation to have consoles with DVD playback on them. That was a big selling point of PS2. Then the Xbox also supported it, but you had to get a DVD remote accessory, but still it had it. And it also had, I just love this generation of consoles. I mean, I grew up with some PlayStation 2 games. I mean, it was even Snoopy vs. the Red Baron. That was one PS2 game I grew up with, because I had a PS3 that was PS2 backwards compatible. I have it down here with me, actually. So it's the same thing I recorded Toy Story and Crash off of. Yeah, I never had any GameCube or games, but I did have some Xbox games. The original Xbox is 360 backwards compatible. And obviously Dreamcast, I never had that till now. I mostly grew up in the 7th gen era. But even with that nostalgia I have, the 6th generation is still my favorite. Whoa! Okay, so that can happen at some times. That's crazy whenever that happens. There we go. Anyways, like I was saying, 6th gen of consoles makes me wet. I mean, I also like the 5th gen too, but a lot nowadays, but the 5th generation games. But I still think the 6th gen is the most consistently solid. People would agree with me on that, but... Oh yeah, I completely forgot to mention the GBA, too. That was 6th generation. I mean, that had the Super Mario Advance games, that had Sonic Advance 1, the pretty decent ports of Donkey Kong Country Trilogy. Obviously the SNES versions are better, usually, but... was another example of that. There's the PS2 and PS1 backwards compatibility. keeping Manic Attack was compatible with both original Game Boy and Game Boy Color. Yeah, I can go on and on and on and on and on and on, and on about this generation of consoles, but... You know, I think I should start talking about Mario Sunshine again, because I've just been rambling. For 10 minutes, almost. So yeah, you can see we're still doing a bunch of blue coins. I'm just gonna grab these. Sometimes it's these shapes. And you gotta get there in time. To grab... that, because it will disappear at some point. If you're not quick. Let's go back up and get those other coins I missed. There was really just one that I missed. Besides, this game is another reason why is one of my main reasons why the GameCube is my favorite console. Even though I've never even played a single GameCube game before 2018. Well, I did play Pac-Man World 2, but I played the PS2 version. Back in the day. Ago. There's just tons of childhood games I can revisit. Just like Pac-Man World 2, which... was another thing, like Mario 64, I came back to it years later and... it's even better than I remembered it being, so... The Wilted Sunflowers. Okay, this is where we... unlock... a certain character. I think. Actually, no. The next shine is... These are Koopas, by the way. This is one of my favorite shines in the game to do as quickly as I can. Because you can spray them out of the ground. Well, you know, before the sunflowers appear. These very anime looking sunflowers. I mean, this game was made by a Japanese company after all, so... it makes sense. Do I sound like an asshole when I say that when I was younger, I always thought Mario... was like a either Nintendo or American. I sound like a total asshole. I don't say that, but dumbass kid me was like that. Yeah, I guess you have the big sunflower. And it gives us a shine. Cool. Look at all those sunflowers. Shine. Hell yeah. Oh no, we do unlock him now. It's because we need him for the next shine. You'll see who I'm talking about. Guess we gotta kill Shadow Mario again. Wanna kill him, but can't take him out. If you're familiar with Mario, you can tell what he's holding right now. It's another character that was... It's iconic. I mean, it was the certain character that was introduced in Super Mario World, which I did talk about. And this game takes place right after it. Yep, Yoshi. Like you just said, this is the first 3D Mario game to have Yoshi as a playable character. I say playable character because he was in Mario 64, but he was only like a cameo. But here you can actually ride him. You can get blue coin with him there. And then over here. I mean, in this game he's totally fine. But I'll be honest, gotta give credit where it's due. I think Super Mario Galaxy 2 is my favorite playable rendition of Yoshi in 3D because, I don't know, he's just used a lot more there. Here he's really only situationally useful, wherever he's required. Which isn't very often. And if you fall in that water there, he dies, so be careful. And it does, it's not really too big of a problem on itself, because it's really not that, it's really easy not to fall in the water, and if you're careful. Let's see, there's that bird. You just eat birds like that too, with Yoshi. And one thing you gotta do with him, which I'm gonna go do that now. I can make this spin jump, there we go. Okay. So anyway, there's that juice meter over there you gotta refill. If it runs out, the Yoshi dies. So, you gotta keep an eye on that too. Thankfully, there's a bunch of fruit placed around here, so it's not that hard to keep it. Whoa! See, Yeah, Yoshi really makes you jump higher. Alright. Now we just gotta wait here. This is... I think this is gonna be the first of the secret shrines that I do. Well, not like secret stages, but... like Delfino Plaza secret stage shrines, because there's... Well, not the first of them, because I did to do the box guy one, but... where we broke the boxes in the time limit. But there's 15 of these. Obviously added because... you know, there's 5 cut levels in development. Yes, you heard me right, 5 levels. It's like Crash to Insanity. There's a lot of cut content. Also, those 2 boats... same time. You don't see that often. It's kind of a rare thing. Yeah, but... here's why I'm not too big a fan of this. We just gotta get Yoshi and we have to wait out here. Yep. Yes, this is it. We just gotta wait here. Isn't this exciting? So I'm just admiring the beauty of the water here, because this is some of the best 6th-gen water that's ever been made. I mean, it looks really, really good. I mean, Mario Sunshine in general looks great overall, but the water is really impressive for this gen of consoles. Love that heat wave effect too. It's just really pretty, okay? Now here's what we gotta do. This is gonna be a stressful moment because we gotta make this jump. We gotta make it count. Just like that, and I'm gonna wait. You have to come back. I'm not gonna risk it. I've been risking it way too much now. For the sake of the Let's Play, I don't want to have to do this more than once. If I'm not recording, I mean, I don't mind too much. But I don't want to bore you guys, if anyone even watches this, that is. Barely anyone does. Isn't this exciting? Ooh. Alright. Here is where we gotta make this jump count. Be extra careful on these jumps. Boom, there we go. Oh, fuck. You see, it turns around like that. That's really obnoxious, but I'll speed this up. Be right back. makes a really tight turn. And, oh my god, I just barely made that. Oh, fuck, okay, we're back. Man, that made my balls clench. Yeah, I mean, I love this game a lot, but I do agree this whole boat ride is not that great. I really wish that the remake was better so they could have streamlined this somehow. This is why I'm great. It's just great because we gotta wait for the remake, if there's ever gonna make be one, which I hope there is, like an actual reignited style remake of these at some point. But seems pretty clear that's not gonna happen. Okay. It's not the worst thing in the world though, so it's doable. If you have patience, but right. Here's what this leads to. The Poison River, as it's called. That water is insta-kill, so you can't swim in it. You gotta come down here with a lily pad with these red coins. Can I get these all in one go? I swear to god, if I get these all in one perfect run, you gotta be kidding me. Okay, usually it takes me a few tries to do that, but yeah. This goes to show you the boat ride is harder than the actual shine. Oh, by the way, do not enter this pipe. This is a trap. This is a Kaizo trap right here. You go in there, you get sent back out to Delfino Plaza. And you have to ride the boats again. No one wants to do that, so do not enter that pipe, no matter what you do. I've no idea why that was put there. It looks like it would send you back to the beginning of the stage, but don't fall for that. Or don't fall for it. Yeah, that's probably one of my least favorite shines in the game, but it's not my least favorite. What is my least favorite one? This one. So I just managed to get in here. Welcome to the Pachinko Machine. This is the worst mission in Super Mario Sunshine by a long shot. I think I have time to do it. 34 minutes, it's fine. But yeah, this is the one shrine that I personally can't defend, no matter what. For one reason, that the physics are really broken. You can get launched out and completely die like that. Because there's a trigger zone. If you know what a trigger zone is, it... Like, if you touch it, it automatically pushes you. For whatever reason, this shine has that. I don't understand why. It's really unnecessary. It just makes it feel more luck-based than anything. I mean, even on my first time, as much as I love Mario Sunshine, this is the shine that I consistently have the most annoyances with. Alright. Actually, I think I'm just gonna go up here because it's... One of these coins. forget exactly which one. But there's actually there's a trick here that I can do. I can walk up this slope to grab this coin down here. But yeah, I mean, the Pachinko cheats, so you might as well cheat back at it. And I think we're about to be done with it. Just gotta grab one more coin. And then we'll be all good. There's one. And so I gotta be... You gotta be extra careful here, because I don't want him to do this. Nobody would. You gotta be super extra careful. Oh! But alright, gotta be extra careful here. Alright. There we go. Got it. Yeah, but that's the worst the game ever gets. So the worst is behind us. So why don't we get that out of the way early? Because I really... Whenever I come back to this, it's the shrine I look forward to the least. Well, that's what we got done with. And, I'm gonna be killed for saying this, I'd rather play Pachinko than most of the motion-controlled mini-games from the Galaxy games. I know, I'm gonna get publicly lynched for saying that, but I don't care. That's what I think. But anyway, that does it for this episode of Super Mario Sunshine. Hope you enjoyed, and join me next time when we get more shines and blue points. Pretty much. See you around.